Guys, it's Iris. Welcome back to my channel. It's haul time. Hi guys, it's Iris. Welcome back to my channel. I have a Dollar Tree haul for you today. It had to be split up into two parts because I went in Dollar Tree today with every intention of today's haul being a themed haul. I am planning on doing more of those for you guys throughout the next couple of months. Continuing them if I can. Pardon me. Oh yeah. By the way, today is National Donut Day. So I hope you were able to participate. I hope you got you a donut. Maybe you got you a free one. But we went and got some donuts this morning. And I got me a Coke. A really big one. Which is so good to me because I have not had caffeine in so long and I have really been feeling it. So anyway, yeah, went in with every intention of my haul today being a themed haul, and well, you know, Dollar Tree just kind of sucked me in and I actually had the extra money to spend today. So I just started picking stuff up that I thought was cute. So this is just my regular haul now. I don't know which one of the hauls I'm going to upload first. I have a themed haul, which is a summer fun haul, and then I have this one. This one will probably be uploaded first, because the themed haul can kind of wait, but these things, I feel like I want to share them now. So let's just go ahead and jump into it. Little Bit is passed out in the back seat. You guys, we went and got our donuts this morning, and he's been in a really foul mood lately, you guys. We went to the arcade yesterday to visit Daddy, and he pitched a fit in the arcade. Usually he is like loving it, running around, having a great time. He pitched a fit there. I asked him if, you know, maybe he was hungry. Did he want a snag? Did he want a cookie? You know, a chocolate milk, a cupcake, something? No, he pitched a fit when I asked him that. He did it again today, you guys. Like, I don't know how many times he was just moody yesterday and just like flipped the switch and just, I wonder where he gets that from. You guys, I am the moodiest person. Anyway, so he did that yesterday. And then today we went and got our donuts. He didn't want anything to do with going in and getting the donuts because we left at the same time as my husband this morning. And he is really daddy-centric when daddy is around. Daddy works a lot so that mommy can be home, and we are so thankful for that. But daddy is at work a lot, so we don't get to see him very often. And when he is home, we try to let him have his time to relax and decompress and do his own thing. But we left at the same time as him this morning, and little man threw a fit. He wanted to go with daddy, so I said, well, okay, daddy will drive us to the apartment office because we had to pay rent today anyway. So we went up there, we got out of the car, we got inside, and then he drove off. We came out and daddy wasn't there, and he flipped his shit, you guys. He was not having it. So I tricked him into getting into my car. We went and got donuts, you guys. The child threw a fit because we wanted to go get donuts. Have you ever known a child to throw a fit because you were going to get donuts? Toddler life. I know. That's what happens. But we got in there. I asked him, did he want a donut? No, he pitched a fit. So we went in the parking lot and he got a good old-fashioned whooping on his booty. And then he went in and got a donut. But he sat there and he wouldn't eat. You guys, it was so cute. We got in the car. He asked for his donut. I said, okay, you can have your donut. The Dollar Tree is, I'm not even kidding, like 2-3 minutes from the Krispy Kreme. And you guys, it was so cute he was already like knocked out. Half of his donut he'd eaten and it was still in his hand, but his hand was just kind of slumped, and he was just, I mean, it looked like he was donut wasted, you guys. It was so adorable. But anyway, he didn't make it home. He is knocked out back there now. So I don't know, I just felt like we needed a story time. I don't know why, but I did. So now let's get in to the haul. So I'm just gonna grab at random. The girl that was working today, I think she was in a bad mood because I heard her say to somebody that she was the only person there, which I find hard to believe, but she says she was. So I feel like she was kind of in a bad mood, but she was trying to force herself not to be. And you guys, she bent my decals. She folded them up and put them in the bag. But they had a lot of, at least new to my store, some new wall decals. I don't know what I'm going to do with these, but I'm sure I will find something to do with them. These are flowers. That's the way that they have them set up in the little picture here. But these are flowers. What are these? I want to say like they're marigolds or maybe gardenia. Something like that. I don't know. Really pretty though. Really pretty pastel floral color. So I like those. I really have no idea what I'm going to do with these, but I thought they were really pretty. These butterflies, you guys, they kind of look, I don't know, like I get like, you know, paisley vibes and hippie and maybe even a little bit of Indian influence in these. You guys, these are so pretty and so right up my alley. Oh my gosh, I don't know what I'm going to do with these, but I'm going to find something. But there's a little picture on those as well. There's a guy, an older gentleman that lives here at the apartments, that he walks the entire property every single day, and he's out there walking right now. He picks up trash, and he's a really cool guy. He was actually featured in our newsletter for this month. He's really, really sweet, you guys, but I see him walking around right now picking up trash. Just made me smile, see him walking around. This one, you're not going to really be able to see what it really is, but it is an air balloon, a hot air balloon, and it says make your dreams come true. You guys, this has to go somewhere around where I film. Like, it just has to. It's got to go like around my vanity or something, because that's my jam, you guys. That is my jam. And it's pretty pastel-y floral colors. Why do I keep calling them pastel floral colors? They're just pastels. Why do I keep calling them floral? I feel like my shirt is on inside, not inside out, but backwards. I have problems with t-shirts where the neck is like right up on me because I feel like I can't breathe. But I digress. So I got those. What is next? Oh, you guys, this was totally just a I saw them and grabbed them type deal. But I got me some new kitchen towels. These are the microfiber ones. Now, you guys, I've got a ton of these microfiber towels from the Dollar Tree. I don't think they hold up great if you're actually using them. If you're using them as kind of like decoration, then they're really good. But these actually match my kitchen perfectly. I actually recently redid my kitchen to be exactly the way that I wanted it. I cleared off all of my counters and brought out all of my nice stuff that we got from when we got married. I finally pulled that all out and set up my kitchen the way that I like it. And I have, like the Fiesta ware, but I don't have like one color. I have all of the colors of the Fiesta ware. And I've also got a couple of, ceramic party pieces that I have out. I've got a bowl and it's striped like this, exactly like this, you guys. So this matches my kitchen perfectly. And I picked up two of these. I don't think I'm going to actually use them, but they will go out as kind of like decoration. So we have those. Got me some more of these paper straws. You've seen me haul these once before. These are from their Spring Fling line. This was a new line they brought out for the springtime. They do that during holidays. They'll have different collections or lines that they bring out. And this is one of the ones from the springtime, from this past spring. So these are just stripey. They kind of match those towels, which is why I picked these up. They had another design that was butterflies, but I like these better. I think they match my motif better, and I do kind of leave these out on the counter. I also got me a facial brush because, you guys, I don't really have anything to exfoliate my face with right now, so I needed something for that, for some deep cleaning, because I don't wear makeup every day anymore. I used to when I was working, of course I wore makeup every day, but now that I'm a stay-at-home mom, I don't really tend to put makeup on every single day. So when I do wear makeup, I feel like my pores suck it in and they get clogged up after one application of makeup. So I feel like I need to be exfoliating more to really get all of that crud out of there. So I got me a little face brush, pick me up some glue sticks because I am running quite low. There are 20 glue sticks in here. These are the small little skinny ones. That's the size that my glue gun takes. So really, really nice to see that they had these at Dollar Tree. Now I knew that they carried glue sticks, but I didn't know that they were this size. So I'm very happy to see that I can get my glue sticks at the Dollar Tree. Next, you guys, I'll do that one in a minute. I got me, this one is kind of boring. I pick up my spices and stuff at the Dollar Tree because they're a buck. They're a lot cheaper than buying them at the grocery store. So I picked me up some more chopped onion because I am just about out. Bag noise, bag noise, bag noise. You guys, I have seen this in the Dollar Tree for a couple of months. I'm going to put some of this stuff back while I'm talking to you. I have seen this item in the Dollar Tree for a couple of months, and I hadn't picked it up because I was like, whatever. That's cool they have that, but I don't need it. But I went ahead and got it today because I was like, you know what? I just want to know what the deal is with this. I got me some Himalayan pink salt. So a couple of years ago, Himalayan pink salt was like really, really expensive. But every time you turned on a cooking show, they were using Himalayan pink salt. So, you know, I said, you know, I'm going to see what this is about. I don't think it really says anything about it. Let's see. This unique pink rock salt has been sourced from the ancient Himalayan mountains to complement any meal. Grind over food before or after cooking and enjoy the flavor. So I don't really know what the deal is with the pink salt. Okay. So this salt actually does not have any iodine in it. So it's not iodized. So I guess it's pure salt, I guess, is the deal with that. But I'm going to try it out just to see how I like it. Oh, little man woke up, you guys. Can you say hi? Can you hear him? He said, eh. Mommy's doing a haul, buddy. Yeah. All right. Let's get this going a little bit more. Pick me up some new hair clips. These are silver and gold. Kind of got a holographic thing going on there. Another set of hair clips, black and cheetah print, because I mean that's my jam. I got me some more of these cleansing sponges. These are microfiber facial pads. You guys, I really, really do like to wash my face with these, but these are really good also for when you're doing like a mud mask or something. These are really good to take that mask off of your face without making a huge mess in your bathroom, because washing off those mud masks can be really, really messy. So I like to use these to take my masks off with. Next, I don't really have an explanation for these, but I got me some new sassy and chic press-on nails. You guys, he's starting to lose it back there. I might have to cut this and move it into the house here in just a minute. But that's okay. Change of scenery is good. But I thought these were really cute. I'm going to finish this bag, and then we are going to take it inside into the house so that he can stretch out, because he is getting fussy. Got me some new hooks. I think these might not work the way that I wanted them to, because these are supposed to go on my outside doors, and I feel like these are going to stick out too much. Now that I'm looking at them, I don't think this is what I wanted. But I got those. And then little man needed some new hangers, so I picked him up a 6-pack of these Essentials hangers. So I'm going to turn the camera off. We're going to go in the house, and we're going to finish this there. Back. So actually, why he was fussy wasn't because he wanted to come inside. He reminded me that I promised him we were going to go to the park today. So he insisted that we go to the park. So we've been at the park for about an hour, 2 hours, something like that. It is freaking hot out there. So we're going to finish up the haul now. I brought in a couple of more items that are actually in my themed haul, my summer fun haul. But I wanted to include them in this one because since I am in the house now, I can actually try this one out. But I got this little mini fan. And I said in the other video that the reason I got this was because I want to see if I can figure out a way to mount this maybe on a headrest or something in the car that blows towards my son's car seat. Because, you know, in the summer it is really hot and it doesn't really, the air doesn't really circulate in the car very well. So I got this to see if I could figure out a way to mount that back there so that he gets some air on him. But I figured since I'm inside now, I put some batteries in it, so I wanted to see how well it actually works. It puts out a good bit of a breeze, you guys. Okay, this is definitely worth a dollar. Oh, you guys. It was so hot out there at that park. Oh, there's a really good park that we like to go to that's on the beach. And we were going to go there and we drove past it. And there were two summer camp buses. So I like kind of just eased past that playground just to see how packed it was. And it was completely swarming with summer camp kids. So we went to another park that is actually like a park. So there's like a lot of trees and a lot of cover, so there's not a lot of sun. It's not as hot. And we were out there for about an hour, and then here comes that same summer camp to this park now. I said, you know what? We're done. We're just going to go home now. So, whew, that was an ordeal trying to get him to leave, though. So I also got him this. It's a little watering can. We have a very small garden on our patio, and he likes to help me with that garden. So I got him this little watering can so that he can help me with this. This was actually in like the beach toys area. I feel like, you see where it's got like this crack in it? I feel like that wasn't like that when I picked it up, but it might have been. So yeah, this maybe not worth a buck, maybe good to take to the beach, maybe not so good for actually watering your flowers. But we shall see. It might have another purpose. I also found this little plastic tumbler. It's the mason jar style tumbler with the little straw, as you can plainly see with your own eyeballs. But it's kind of summer themed. It says smile. It's got a little popsicle, some sunglasses, and a slice of watermelon. I actually did get this for him. I do want to see, though, if I can find some more of these. This was actually by itself on a shelf that it wasn't supposed to be on, and I saw it and thought it was cute, so I snatched it up. But I did not see any more of these in my store. So I'm going to be on the lookout for some more of these because I do want some more of those. Now, let's finish this out. I only had two bags left, and then I decided I wanted to bring those things into this haul as well. But you guys, this was a little bit frivolous of me. I really don't have any reason for these. Hopefully I will soon, because I'm thinking I'm probably going to buy a coffee pot this weekend. Because mama needs some caffeine. But I found some coffee mugs that I did not expect to see at Dollar Tree. You guys, you're probably going to laugh at me, but they're Duck Dynasty mugs. This one says, "I promise, but I ain't signing no contract." And it's got Willie on it. You guys, my husband actually really, really enjoys Duck Dynasty. And that is not something that I expected from him. But Duck Dynasty is filmed in my hometown of Monroe, Louisiana. And so, you know, I got kind of a soft spot for them Duck Commander boys. So there's that one. I think in total there are six of these mugs. There's another one that I thought was very patriotic and fitting for the 4th of July. But it's all the guys. It's, well, not all the guys. Because Jeff is not on here. I don't know why Jeff is never on any of the merchandise, but it's got Phil and Willie and Jace on that mug, and it's red, white, and blue. I should have unwrapped these before I started doing this. I'm going to save that one for last. I'm going to save save that one for the same time that I do that other one. Get these two. This is just standard Duck Dynasty that it has on there with the four guys on it again. Well, Sai's not on this one, is he? Oh, yeah, Sai is on this one. Yeah. So we got Willie. Well, now I forgot Daddy's name, and I just did that. Phil. Phil, Willie, Sai, and Jace on this one with a little Duck Dynasty logo on it. Man, I am showing my Southern with this one, aren't I? That's okay. And then this one, I really like this one. It's got a picture of Phil on it. And it's got the little Duck Dynasty right there. But then it says, move it on, yuppie. Yeah, you gotta love Phil. You gotta love him. I like that one, though. That's really cute. This set right here, I don't know, this might end up being a gift for somebody, but I have this one that's kind of a camo, but if you look really close, the Duck Dynasty camo, or the Duck Commander camo is always ducks, but it just says Duck Dynasty all the way around it. And then there's the pink one that is the pink camo with the ducks. This might end up being a gift set, like a His and Hers gift set. I haven't decided yet. I really wish, you know what, I should have picked up another one of these pink ones because I really like this pink camo. My mom actually has a bottle of wine, a Duck Dynasty wine, that has the pink camo on the bottle. And it's really pretty, and that's what this kind of reminds me of. So that is it for this haul, you guys. I hope you enjoyed it. He wants to be cooled off. He's giving me his fan. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this haul. If you did, give it a thumbs up. If you've not already, hit the subscribe button down below. While you're at it, hit the bell next to it. That's going to give you notifications on when I post new videos. Also, if you have not already done so, follow me on Instagram as well. It's BiloxiBeauty82, exactly the same way that it's spelled here. I forgot what I was saying for a second. Is that everything? Is that everything? Again, you guys, if you liked the video, please give it a thumbs up. That pushes my video out to other people and gets me more exposure. It puts me on other people's suggested watch lists so that I get more viewers and I get more subscribers. And that's what we want here, you guys. I'm just throwing it out there. If I hit 100 followers or 100 subscribers pretty soon, might be a giveaway in the works, you guys. I'm just throwing it out there. Should we do a giveaway when I hit 100 subscribers? Because you guys know I've been struggling for these 100 subscribers for a while, and I think a giveaway would be in order, don't you? I think so. So give it a like, give it a thumbs up, send some more people my way. I will see you guys later. Bye.